Hey, let's talk about getting a job, especially if you just got out of college, or maybe you're thinking about going to college and hoping that when you're done with that process, you'll be able to get a decent job that pays you well. But sometimes you're not sure exactly how to get from point A to point B, and oftentimes colleges claim that they're the bridge to that pathway. Well, I wanted to share a simple, I guess, technique that most people overlook and sort of just expose that colleges really aren't the bridge that they sometimes say they are or that we place them to be in our minds. So I want to take a look at some job descriptions. I'm currently looking for a job as a data scientist or a machine learning engineer. I went to a boot camp. I'm confident that I know how to do most of the things that are said in these job descriptions, but I want to just expose or show that there's a lot more to job hunting and going from point A to point B that's required than just going through a program or going to school or going through a boot camp. So let's look at my computer. I've got a few options picked out already. Hopefully, you can see most of the description here. So let's look at Big Fish here, data scientist. So it's looking for a bachelor's degree, statistics or related discipline, mathematics, economics, computer science. Most of you know I have an undergraduate degree in marketing, so I'm not there. I have experience in SQL and Python. Yeah, I've done all of this stuff in school or just like on my own for this YouTube channel. And then it's a minimum of 1 to 3 years of data science function, which I do not have. So let's look at another here at Walmart. Walmart's pretty funny. If we scroll down to what they want, minimum qualifications are required. Below, if none are listed, there are no minimum qualifications. So this might be one worth looking into and seeing if you would get in. Let's try M&T Bank, machine learning and automation developer. Their education requirements, minimum of associate's degree with 5 years system analysis application development in lieu of a degree, combined minimum of 7 years higher education and or work experience, including a minimum of 5 years system analysis application development experience. It sounds oddly like both inclusion, very including, but also very specific. Like, I don't know, it's opening people up so that maybe you don't need a bachelor's or a master's degree. Simple bet. 2+ years experience in machine learning, NumPy, know all that good stuff. Strong passion for NFL, sure. Strong understanding. Okay, so this one, if you had 2 years and some relevant experience, that might be something worth applying to. But it's weird because it's like an entry, it's listed as entry level. But if you already have 2 to 3 years of data science experience, I wouldn't necessarily consider that entry level. Game time, 2 to 5 years data analyst experience. Say anything about education level? No, it doesn't. So this might also be something worth applying to if you had relevant experience beforehand. But remember, we're coming at this as people who just got out of a undergraduate degree course. Let's see. Looking for more data scientists. Bachelor's or master's in data analytics, computer science, or proven work experience. Okay, so that's pretty open. You might get something there. Data science intern. Sure. So let's get out of LinkedIn. I've actually found that LinkedIn's not the best job reporting or job posting site, actually. So here we go. Here's data science for this. We're now on Indeed. And let's say in our scenario, I am somebody with some experience. I've been in the workforce for a few years, and I want to both switch roles and I'm willing to switch industries as well. So I go to a continuing education program at a university, and I get a certificate that shows that I've learned, you know, statistical analysis, Python, NumPy, Matplotlib, as well as regression models, random forest models, and I'm able to even build some very basic neural networks. And I have a portfolio of projects where I have shown competency with data science work. So I go to Indeed and I'm about to apply for this data science role here at Blackstone. And you can see here, undergraduate degree in computer science or related field plus 4+ years of data-driven professional setting, along with some other technical skills that you would need that they're looking for. So 4+ years, you know, that's probably something I don't have as a entry-level data scientist. So let's look at machine learning engineer here at Transatlantic Reinsurance. What do they want from us? 3+ years of demonstrated excellence in building, scaling, and productizing machine learning models. Okay, anything about education? Not really. Kaggle ranking of expert or higher, a plus. Gotcha. So that's, this might be something worth trying, but the 3+ years of demonstrated excellence in building, so this is not an entry level position, basically. Senior data scientist, it's probably way out of my league to go from, you know, entry. I'm looking for like entry level data scientist here, but let's say you wanted to roll the dice and see what they were looking for at Capital One. Bachelor's degree plus 2 years in data analytics or a master's degree or PhD. So you would want, you know, you'd be better off. You'd be basically, if you had an undergraduate degree here, what this is saying is you're competing against candidates with master's and PhDs. So you're probably going to get passed up for that. What about a K-Force? They want solid experience. Get rid of this. They want solid infrastructure background, 2+ years in machine learning. Okay, so not really entry level. It doesn't really say anything about education, so this might be worth applying to, if as long as you had some other competitive advantage to make you stand out. What about Liberty Personal Services in New Jersey? This one looks pretty open. You know, they just want the strong skill set. If you can show that you've done some Scikit-learn, XGBoost, Keras, and TensorFlow, and just like some proficiency in Python or C++, I think you'd be good. Oh, it says bachelor's degree in computer science. Right, so if you don't have a bachelor's degree in computer science, you're competing with others who do. You can just like assume that as something you'd have to work against. What about Entropy Network? The following are required. Sure, I don't even know why you would. Obviously, you wouldn't even apply unless you had those, but it doesn't really say anything about bachelor's degree or master's. Let's try Enigma. Our ideal candidate has 4+ years of software experience plus 2 years building machine learning systems at scale. Enjoys collaborating cross-functional. Anything else? Learning data. Do they care about education? Doesn't really look like it. But again, if you have 4+ years of software development experience, along with 2 years of machine learning systems, like this is not an entry level position. XSG-S. Yeah, this is like pretty basic. Yeah, this is like super basic. You have no idea what, you know, they're just looking for the hard skills. Can you show you have the hard skills there? Although, why isn't it? Oh, sorry, I didn't scroll down. They want 4 to 8+ years of experience. All right, so if you're just coming into the industry as a machine learning engineer, you may be able to build neural networks, but if you don't have 4 to 8+ years of experience, you're most likely competing with people who do at least have more experience than you as someone coming at, straight out of school. So why am I basically here? Why am I even showing you all this? The reason I'm doing this is because I think it's important to remember that if you are transitioning from one role to another, or if you're thinking about what you want to be when you grow up, or if you're in school and you're trying to figure out what your job prospects are going to be, just like go to one of these sites and type in the ideal like title that you're going to be shooting for and see what the job descriptions just say. Because I think more often than not, we're told and we're thought to think that, you know, if I just go to school and I get a degree in marketing, I'm going to be able to get a job as a marketer. Or if I go to school and I get my AWS cloud certification, I'm going to get hired as an IT person. Or, you know, if I go to this boot camp, I'm going to get hired for this. Those things are true. That's the first step toward that goal. That's the right way to think. I'm not bashing the decisions to go to school or the decisions that help you transform your current state to your future state. But what I am getting at is that before all those things begin, you can go ahead and just take a look at the job market through these postings and see how your experience is going to stack up to the expectations that the market is looking for. So for someone like me, I don't have a master's degree or a PhD. And in my search for these types of roles, I've noticed that that's the preferred degree level. The other thing that's stacked against me is that I don't have an undergraduate degree in computer science or statistics or anything in STEM. So that's another thing stacking against me. I'm not complaining. I made my decisions and so did everyone else. But these are pretty competitive roles. And I'm assuming if you're, you know, trying to also get a nice job that you're interested in, they're going to be competitive too. So just keep that in mind when you're thinking about what it is that you want to do and how you're going to get yourself from, you know, your current state to your, you know, desired state. And your educational bit that you're going to do, it's not a guarantee. It's just another way to strengthen your profile. And that's kind of how you need to think about it. If you're going about this, I would suggest that you try to find ways to make yourself stand out and give yourself a competitive advantage that others may not have. So that's just my little tidbit for today. I thought it would be, you know, a useful little technique that you can use if you're not someone who's already in a program, or if you're just curious, you know, what your experience job hunting is going to be like. You can just search for the job and look for it. It seems really simple, but it's something I never did. And it's something I wish I would have, because it would have planned my journey. I would have planned my journey much more effectively had I just done this from the very beginning. So yeah, that's about it. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.